What's up, guys? We're here for another episode of Portugal Back to Back. We are in the most northern region of the country. We're past Aveiro, we're past Porto, we are in the region of Minho, really the deadline between Portugal and Spain. Right behind us, we have Viana do Castelo, where the Rio Lima flows into the ocean. And a little bit further north, you have the Rio Minho that really separates Portugal and Spain. This area is quite special because you have a very nice connection between the ocean and the mountains. Right behind us, we have Gerês, Barcelos, Ponte Lima, some beautiful mountain areas where you can really, you know, find crystal clear lagoons and, you know, check out waterfalls, hike in the mountains, and you can surf in the morning and do all that in the afternoon, which is quite unique. Yeah, Viana do Castelo is quite special. It's not so known for surfing, but you have amazing places such as Praia da Arda, Vila Praia da Âncora, Moledo, all very good waves that I haven't been in a very long time, and that's the beauty of Portugal Back to Back. It brings me to places that I haven't been in a very long time. So yeah, we got Salvador Couto with us, a local surfer from the northern region. He started surfing right here in Viana do Castelo, that's right.
Yeah, I'm super happy to be here with you. And the forecast is looking a bit bad. We're gonna make the most out of it. We're gonna surf there in Cabedelo. It's a really one of the best spots here, actually. So yeah, let's see how it goes.
That's it, my boys. We're gonna go surfing with Salvador here in Viana do Castelo. We're also gonna meet up with Marta Passos, blind surfing world champion, adaptive surfing world champion. She's from this region, an absolute legend. She inspires us on a daily basis. And everything is ready for some fun. Let's go.
Let's go. We'll be right back.
What a day. So fun to be here up north, you know, spending a day with Salvador, surfing Muledo. I mean, such an incredible wave. I grew up seeing pictures of Muledo, this perfect left just rolling down. And funny enough, today we rock up and it's not a left, it's a right.
Yeah, the waves were actually pretty fun and just a really magical place with no one out.
I guess the best part of all that, sharing an afternoon session with Marta Paz. She's so inspiring to all of us. She's an adaptive surfing world champion. She's blind. She's been surfing for the last 6 years. She's got 2 world titles. I mean, surfing blind is just mind-blowing. You know, the resilience, the commitment, the trust in the process you have to have. It really fills my heart to see something like that. There she is right now. What a champion, huh? So incredible to surf with you in the water. And you as well, Thiago, the coach. A couple weeks ago, I had the pleasure to try out blind surfing, and it was so challenging. Most of the people have never had that feeling. So I think it's really interesting. You're one of the few in the world that surfs as good, and you're also world champion. Tell us, I mean, what's the feeling of riding a wave?
I don't know, because I never surfed like normally. But I think it's all about feeling. It's all about you using the other senses. You have to use your hearing, your touch, and you mix it all and you just feel. And you have to just know. Because my coach did an incredible job teaching me, showing me, touching me and say, hey, you have to do this and you have to go down. And it's all about explaining. There's no seeing videos of others.
Did you ever imagine that Marta was going to be, how many times world champion?
2.
2 times world champion.
No. We started to develop together, the methodology.
Communication.
Yeah, and now it's world champion and growing the surfing and the conquest of the world.
That's amazing, Marta. You are a true testament of resilience, commitment, of courage. I mean, what you do is incredible and inspires us, you know, in many ways, inspires so many people to really push outside of their comfort zone. And I'm so glad that we spent this moment here in Vienna,
yeah,
surfing with you.
It was a pleasure.
And yeah, so amazing, huh? So this is it, guys. We surfed Muledo this morning. We surfed with Marta Passo here in Viena do Castelo, together with Surf Club Vienna and Thiago. Salvador was also present, and this is it. This place is beautiful. It's an amazing balance between nature and mountains. We had the surfing part, now it's about time to check out the other beautiful places Minho region has to offer. Let's go. This view.
Amazing.
Finishing off the trip here, guys, in Serra d'Arga, one of the highest points in Minho region. You can see the beach right there. You can see Viena do Castelo.
Look at this peaceful place, man. What an amazing place. I cannot deal with this view. You can almost see Porto there, Porto City.
That's Porto right there.
So far away.
Crazy. This must be one of the highest points in Portugal as well, like top five.
Actually, I have no clue, but we are super high. We're like, what, 800 meters?
Do you think it snows here sometimes?
Yeah, for sure.
Talking about Viena right there, I heard the myth of how the name of Viena do Castelo stands from. Viena do Castelo, which means I saw Anna of the castle. And there was this princess called Anna that lived up the castle. And this guy saw Anna in the castle one day because she didn't appear. She was very beautiful, very shy. She didn't appear very often. And he saw her in the castle and went around town screaming, Viena do Castelo! And that's how it started.
That's an incredible myth. That's really funny.
That's pretty cool. I heard it the other day and I thought I'd tell you. But I mean, walking around these towns of Minho, which is an incredible place, like Viena, Ponte Lima, you can really feel, you know, it's like a living canvas of classical architecture. You feel the Renaissance, the baroque style in the buildings, in the churches, in the castles. It's really beautiful.
Everywhere.
I mean, yeah, it's like everything is built of rock, probably the same rock as this as we're standing.
And everywhere we go, it's just so beautiful and the houses are so well kept. And it's just amazing to go in the city and see all the monuments and just touch on the rock that was made like 200 years ago, you know, and it's just a special feeling, you know.
It's incredible. But it's been a really fun trip. I mean, surfing with you, we didn't get the greatest waves either, but it was pretty fun.
Yeah, we still made a few ones.
You got a couple waves in Lille and the beach break as well. And surfing with Marta Paz, you know.
That was an insane opportunity.
That was incredible. She's just such a warrior, right?
Yeah, and the way just how inspiring it is that she goes surfing and she cannot see anything, and how can she stand up on the wave and just go down the life, just pure feeling it.
And I was so impressed how fast she was going.
Yeah.
But it's been an amazing trip, huh? Thanks for joining us, Salvador.
Thank you for the opportunity, Nick. It was insane to hang out with you. I mean, you're a huge inspiration for me, and just having the opportunity to go surf with you these days was insane. And yeah, I'm super grateful, and thank you so much.
You take it home.
This was the Minho, and we had amazing food, we had amazing wine, we visited amazing monuments. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Let's go, guys. Portugal Back to Back, episode Minho was a blast. See you guys in the next one. Let's go.